यंत्रोमित्रा फ्रॉम क्रिएटिविटी टू इनोवेशन।
हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज अक्षिता प्रमोद फ्रॉम यंत्रोमित्रा। टुडे वी वुड बी लर्निंग हाउ टू कनेक्ट आवर आर्डुइनो यूनो टू आवर कंप्यूटर टू चेक इफ इट्स कनेक्टेड प्रॉपरली एंड आल्सो टू राइट अ सिंपल प्रोग्राम ऑन टू आवर आर्डुइनो यूनो टू ब्लिंक इट। वी ऑल नो that the Arduino Uno would have a cable which looks something like this. This part should go to the computer and this part should be connected to the Arduino. So this is how it looks. The rectangular or the one which has a U-ish bend would go to the Arduino Uno rectangular input and the USB part would be connected to the computer. It can be connected to this port or to this port. Now, in order to check if it is connected properly, you have to open your Arduino Uno sketch. So let us go to File, New. So this is my new sketch that I have here. And I'll just click on Tools and I'll just say Board Arduino Uno. And I see that the port, nothing has been selected. It's like gray, which means that I have not connected it properly. Now, I'll just connect the USB to my computer here. And I'll go to Tools, Arduino Uno, and it's connected to COM9. COM9 has my Arduino Uno connection. So with this, we have showed that we have done a successful connection because I can see my LED lighting up. You will see it too. Now, let's do the connection required to write our program. For this, I am using my Arduino Uno, breadboard, LED, and a resistor here. So let me connect my LED on the breadboard. Now let me connect the resistor. Make sure the resistor is connected in such a manner that the cathode, the shorter terminal of the LED and one terminal of the resistor are in the same line. Now let us do the rest of the connection. I will connect the ground. I'm connecting the 13 pin to the positive terminal here. The 13th pin is the pin that we are using in the code. Therefore, this will be the pin that will give us the voltage required for glowing the LED. So next connection that you do is connect your resistor to the negative terminal in the breadboard. So this is the one of the terminal of the resistor. Connect this to the negative line. Anywhere here you can connect. I'm just connecting it here. Connect either of these lined holes to the negative line over here. Next connection that we have to do is to connect the anode, that is the longer terminal of the LED that you have connected to the breadboard, to the positive line here. You can connect it again in any of the holes. I'll just connect it here. With this, you have connected the connections required. Now, let us go back to our sketch, Arduino sketchbook. So this is where you would be writing your code. As soon as you open a new file, you would already have a void setup and a void loop. So now I'm going to write my code here. So this is where I've written my code. And in the void setup, I have written pin mode. Pin mode is indicating the pin on which we will see the output, that is where your anode is connected. So this is pin number 13, and pin number 13 would be your output. And in your void loop, you would write digital write. In digital write, W should be in caps. Similarly, in pin mode, your M would be in caps. And pin mode would indicate on which pin you will see the output or which pin you have connected your anode of the LED. And so similarly, you have your digital write. where W is in caps, a high indicates that your LED is high, that is your LED is on, and opposite half high is low, and that low indicates your LED is off. And I've written a delay here, delay of 1000 milliseconds. So after 1000 milliseconds, it will be off, or after 1000 milliseconds, it will be on. So it's a cycle that's going to happen. So in order to upload the code onto your Arduino Uno, you would be pressing this button called as the upload. So before uploading, you should make sure that your code is absolutely correct. You will get to know if your code is wrong when an error occurs while uploading. For example, okay, and also you should remember that similar to writing a full stop, after completion of each sentence, you have a semicolon in each of the codes that I've written here. So don't miss out those two, because if you miss them out, you'll have an error. Just like how I'm going to get an error now. I have removed the code in pin mode and I'll just go for the upload and I'll save it in my drive and all of those. But as soon as I try to upload, I'm getting the error message. It is saying that expected a semicolon before the end of the void setup. So I should write a semicolon there. So I just type my semicolon. And as I upload now, without any hatch or without any errors, it's just gonna get uploaded. So it's uploading here. So done uploading. And we have just uploaded our code now. And now we're going to see how it's actually going to look. Let us start the simulation. The connection has been done perfectly. That's where we can see the blinking of our LED. With this, you have just learned how to write the code for the blinking of the LED using the breadboard, and how to transfer it from your PC or computer to the Arduino Uno. Thank you. Signing off, Akshita Pramod.
Dear viewers, you can now purchase Yantromitra Steam Kits through the link given below in the description. Yantromitra Steam Kits come with multiple projects, DIY booklet, and video tutorials to help our students do the DIY experiments. Yantromitra Steam Kits are delivered to your doorstep on the basis of one kit per month.
Yantromitra, from creativity to innovation.